Hello everyone. Welcome to maths class. Hope you all are staying safe. Let's make our brain a little active. Okay, so for today, we will learn geometrical construction, the very first chapter of class 7th maths textbook. Geometrical construction. Okay, geometry means what? Yes, we have to deal with the tools inside this geometry box. Let's recall what we have learned in lower classes. Figure A. Figure A is called what? Line. Why? Because it has two arrow heads. If these two arrow heads are not there, then this will be called as what? Line segment. That means what? If it has two end points, then it will be called as line segment. And if it has only one arrowhead and at the other end it has a point, it has end point and the arrowhead, then it will be called as ray. Then figure D is called what? Angle. What does this arrowhead indicate? It means that this can be extended infinitely. This can be extended infinitely. No specific measurement is given. Okay. So, in class 7, what are you going to learn? We will learn how to make perpendicular bisector of a line segment. You know what is line segment? This you can see. Yes. So, perpendicular bisector means what? Perpendicular. Perpendicular means 90 degree and bisector means cutting into equal parts. So if this is a line segment, this we will do like this. This line is bisecting the line segment. So why we are calling it as perpendicular bisector? As you can see, if this line segment, yes, so the angle made here is what? 90 degree. So this bisection is called as perpendicular bisector. How to do this now? Now see, this is what? Line segment. Let us measure that. How much? 6 centimeter. Now how to make perpendicular bisector? Yes, with the help of this compass. What we will do? We will keep the pointer at one end. Fix it properly first. Then take more. This is what? Half of the line segment. Take more than half. Extend it. Then from one end of the line segment, why it is not coming? Yes, because our pencil is not inserted properly. So insert it properly. From one end, mark arc upside and below also. From the other end, that is at point B, mark the arc upside and below. Then you can see the cross. So what we have to do? Just join these two intersection of the arcs and make a straight line. So this is what? 90 degree. Got it? In similar way, I'm giving you one more example. See, Now this measures how much? 8.5. This is given as name A, B. Then what we have to do? Keep the pointer at one end, extend. This is half, this is approximately half of the line segment. Extend it. Why? Because I have said more than half. So this is more than half. And from one end, mark one arc upside and one below. Go to point B, mark one arc upside and one below. Now what? Just we have to intersect. We have to join these two points. Got it? So in this manner, you have to draw perpendicular bisector of a line segment. Any line segment will be given. You have to construct it like this. As you can see, practice it. One, the very first part of your exercise is what? Draw line segment of length given below and draw the perpendicular bisector. Just you have to make 5.3 line segment, and in this similar manner you have to make the perpendicular bisector. Similarly, 6.7, draw the line segment, make the perpendicular bisector in this manner. Okay, got it? So can you do this? Practice it. One, first part. Okay. Now, second topic we will learn in this chapter is what? How to make angle bisector of the given angle. Now, you know what is angle. You know how to draw angle also. So, how to make angle bisector of a given angle. You know what is angle. How to make angle, you also know that. Let us measure. This is what? 60 degree. How we will see? If you are seeing from the right side, then you have to see the below measurements. Okay. So how to make the bisector? Bisector means what? I have told you, cutting it into two equal parts. So we will need again the help of this tool. What we will do? Keep it at the point, extend it a little, and then make one arc at one arm and the second arc at the second arm. Then what we have to do? Extend it a bit and from one arc draw the arc. From the second arc you have to draw the second arc. This, as you get the intersection of the arc. Now what we have to do? Yes, we have to join this to this point. So this total angle is what? 60 degree. So this angle must be 30 and this must be 30. Why? Because this bisector cuts the whole angle into two equal parts. Let us measure. So can you see it is coming exactly 30? So this is 30 degree and this is 30 degree. Similarly, for 90 degree angle, same manner you have to do. First, extend it a little. One arc at one arm. Then, See, this is getting loose. Then extend it a bit from the second arc. Then what? Now this angle is of 90 degrees. So this should be how much? 45 degrees. And this should be also 45 degrees. Why? Because this is the angle bisector. Let us measure. See. 40, 45. So what we have done is exactly correct. Now for obtuse angle. Let us see for obtuse angle. See, this is of 130 degrees. Now similarly, we have to do, first what we will do, extend it a bit, then keep at the, then make one arc at one arm, second, don't touch it, don't change the measurement, similar, with the same measurement you have to make the arc on second arm, then what we will do, extend it a bit, then keep at one arc, then from the second arc this, and what we will do, we will join this to this point. Let us measure. Where's my pen? Where's my protractor? See, this was 130 degree. So half of 130 will be how much? 65. So this is coming to 65. So other one is also 65. It is cutting exactly at the middle. Means this angle bisector. What it does? It cuts the angle into two equal parts. This is part 1, this is part 2. Got it? We can name this. For example, this A, B. This as C. This L, M, N, X, Y, Z. Got it? How to make the angle bisector of the angle bisector of the given angle. So in your textbook, the very first exercise, what you have to do, draw a line segment of the lens given below and draw the perpendicular bisector. How you're going to do that? Like this, as I have shown you. And the second part is what? Draw angles of the measure given below and draw their bisector. How you are going to do this? Exactly the same manner as I have taught you. Only what will change? The measurement of the angle. What is that? 105, 55, 90 degree. So can you all do this? Two parts? Okay. Thank you so much.